Hollywood Squares Hour with, from Happy Days, Erin Moran. From Old Madeline, Jane Sloyan. From Another World, Nancy Frangione. Fred Travellina. Charles Nelson Reilly. And the stars of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman. No!
Okay, get that up from here. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Are you hangovers from yesterday's show?
Yeah!
Oh, you are.
Yeah, they moved down.
Are you just hangovers? Are you all ready here?
Hey.
This is the end of the week, isn't it?
End of yes. the week.
We're going to be brilliant, aren't we?
Absolutely.
We're going to be amusing and wonderful. And
turkey.
And I got a hangover from last night.
Oh.
I'm sorry, I spit a little because it's all the dental work.
What was that, Charles?
It's all...
Oh, nothing.
You
it's
were
okay.
checking my
adhesive no, tape. No, it wasn't.
I got a cut in my neck.
No, Charles, you would never know.
I know.
No one would ever know.
I
my
know.
Lips are
it's
sealed forever.
It's my grandfather's tie. You knew that.
Yes. No, the one thing I want to point out is those of you who were tuned in earlier in the week and saw Charles wear a sweater
same
that looked
thing.
Like this.
Yes.
He has two
Shame.
Sweaters
two
identical.
Sweaters that look like.
Same.
You know, Orphan Annie has 14 dresses the same.
Same thing, sure.
Same
Why
thing.
Shouldn't you have two sweaters that look the same? Nothing wrong with that. All right, here we go now. We'll say hello to our chairs there. Robert Malcheski and Sharon Sawhill.
That's right.
Find out about Robert. Tell us about you, please.
I'm a paste-up artist with a local newspaper. I'm
yeah.
a Navy veteran, and I just got my degree in theater arts from Cal State Long Beach.
Yeah. You mean a local newspaper?
A big city local newspaper.
Oh. What the heck? Why doesn't he just say the Los Angeles Times and be done with it? I mean, there's only one newspaper. How many papers are there here? I don't read the local.
Several?
Oh, well, then all right. Then you say a local newspaper.
Local newspaper.
All right, Robert, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Sharon, what do you tell us about you, please?
I'm married. I have two children, Michael and Matthew, and another one on the way in June. My husband was transferred to Phoenix 2 years ago.
In the nick of time, I might say.
We can't wait to come back. I'm
he
a
wants
native
to come
Californian.
Back? Yeah. What does your husband do?
He's an accountant.
All right. That's okay with me. Let him be an accountant. If he wants to be an accountant, that's all right with me. Now, here in the match game, you'll have three chances to match as many of the ding-a-lings as you can. The one who's done that most often will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Robert, you won the toss, therefore you go first.
A, please.
A it is for you.
We're getting worse.
Mary said.
Mary?
Mary.
She's from New Zealand? From the Maori tribe?
Mary said.
Maori?
My new husband is really insecure. On our honeymoon... He brought along his blank. That's how insecure he is. Everybody ready in the upper and lower tiers? Shall we come over here to Robert? Mary said, my new husband is really insecure. On her honeymoon, he brought along his blank.
His teddy bear.
Teddy bear is good. I mean, that's... A well-known symbol of insecurity is a teddy bear. Mm. Security blankets, all that sort of thing. What do you say, Nancy?
It was my first instinct.
And you didn't say
no,
it?
No,
oh, you didn't say it.
I didn't. I went with the old
security blanket.
Blanket.
That's good, though. That's very good. Teddy
enough.
Bear, security blanket, excellent. Fred?
You know, when I was the former president of the United States...
Yes, Mr. President.
I had a lot of insecurities. I really did. I had alphabet soup. 18 letters were missing.
What else, Mr. President?
I started to get stuck on words like law and order, law and order, law and order. So I brought along a lawyer.
A lawyer.
Right. Uh-huh.
on our honeymoon yes, grill along his...
Well, oh, there is a teddy bear in his lapel.
This is Bogey. I do the voice of Bogey on the Shirt Tales.
Ah.
For the Saturday morning for the kids. Uh-huh. How you doing, sweetheart? Nice to see you. See? But insecure, he'd bring a lawyer. See, then, okay.
It's all right. It's all right with me, Fred.
All right, sweetheart.
Anything you say is
that's
all
right
with
because
me.
That's what I said, too.
You
said
the same thing. You said teddy bear.
It's teddy bear, kind of, in a peculiar fashion.
Spelling doesn't count, Buster.
Yeah, I know.
You know, spelling doesn't count here. I don't care how he spelled it. As long as he said teddy bear, it makes her happy. Okay, let's see what you got.
James Cagney.
Right. As I live and breathe. Well, you know, I don't know why I said this, but the imagination is a wonderful thing. I said he brought along his ex-wife. Hey, this is pretty funny. This is clever. This is garbage.
All right,
Aaron.
You're
going to love this one, then.
Let's take a look at yours.
Ex-girlfriend.
If you reread the question, Bogey, it would have gone over.
What do you say,
Chuck? Brought along his chick.
Oh. Brought along his chick, eh? Well, you picked up and won in spite of them. Are you ready for yours, sweetheart? Mm-hmm. Okay, here it is. Linda said, that new karate school is kinky. Stay out of show business. New karate school is kinky. Instead of black belts, all the men wear black blankets. Ah.
Hey, I got a defective card. Look at this. It's a defective card. It has no black border.
Uh-huh.
Don't use that. Throw that one away. Right in there. Discard slot. You finished, Fred. You didn't put it in the slot.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
All right, now here we go with Sharon. Linda said that new karate school is kinky. Instead of black belts, all the men wear black blanks.
Garters?
Garters. All right. All right. Logic there. Right, Nancy?
Yeah, it's a good answer. Doesn't allow for much freedom of movement, but neither would this.
Brassier. All right. That's a good answer,
Brassiers?
Too.
Brassiers? Is that correct?
Yes, Brassiers. That's it.
Well, you know, before I went on to the show, this fantasy island, you know, I wanted to study karate.
Oh, you did.
And then I went and ordered my favorite donuts. The plain.
Oh, what kind of donuts?
I said lace stockings.
Lace stockings is good. Black lace stockings. All right, Jim.
Ta-da, I said garters.
Garters. All right, John.
I'll only answer if you do tag me again.
All right, John, anything you say.
Okay. Do you do Lacey as well?
Yes, I do.
I said athletic supporters.
That's a good one.
Very good.
Black jockstrap. All right, Aaron.
I said pantyhose.
Pantyhose. Boy, that is a kinky karate school. The kinky karate
now,
school.
Now, I think this...
Whoa! What was that?
Encore!
One more time.
Encore!
When she was down there.
There he is.
Look at her.
She's a dancer, I can tell.
My glasses.
Glasses are steaming
are
up.
Are fogging over. This, I think, is a match, fellas. Honest to God. Think
now,
about
watch
it
carefully
a
now. This may be
no,
a match.
Serious. It
yes,
should be.
Seriously.
A...
Right.
I said a studded garter belt.
A studded garter belt. All right. Goodbye. All right, well, you got to hear the rest of it. Hold on.
With leather chaps and high heels.
Oh, all right, so Sharon, you're ahead at the end of round one, 2-1. Good game going here. Tune in for round two right after this.
Hi, Buzzer fans. Hey, join me, Bob Eubanks, for my picks of some of my favorite episodes from Card Sharks.
Do you think you could beat Bob Eubanks in arm wrestling?
Trivia Trap, Match Game, Hollywood Squares.
You're a male goat.
Oh, come on.
Family Feud. And what's that other one again? Oh, I know what it is. The Newlywed Game.
Good luck at the family reunion this year.
It's the best of Bob during Bobtober here on Buzzer.
Continues tomorrow starting at 8. Let's play.
You're ahead. Therefore, we ask you to go first.
Me, please.
Okay. Thumbdore is so dumb. Thank you. She studied all night just to take a blank test. Charles, why am I helping you? You don't write anyway. But he's got a good answer. We'll reveal it later.
Let's see how I manage to get the camera on me.
All right, here we go. Sharon. Dumbdore is so dumb she studied all night just to take a blank test.
Blood test?
Blood test is her answer. All right, you're up first.
Listen, I said this, but this is a tough test. She wouldn't be so dumb to pass it. They're making it tough.
A driver's test. Well, she would be smart to study for that, wouldn't she? Fred?
Knock it off.
Well, in the words of Jack Nicholson, I certainly hope I'm going for the gold this year, statue about that high. Mm. I said a blood test.
Uh-huh. That's got through. Okay, John, we're up to you.
Yeah. I said pap test.
All right. Naturally, a woman would think of an answer like that.
Well, John.
All right, go.
I said cooking.
Cooking test.
Woo bad.
Charles had an interesting answer. I just want him to show and tell. What'd you do with it?
Right here.
Is that it?
This is half of it.
Oh, he said Rorschach test. You know, the psychological test. Rorschach. Oh, I tried to help him with the spelling. I didn't know. Wasn't too sharp. Anyway, Sharon, you're up to three. Robert, you got a little catching up to do. Vinny said, when I was a kid, we were so poor, I had to share a bed with two brothers, three sisters, and a half a dozen blanks. That's how poor we were. Had to share a bed.
With who?
Two brothers, three sisters, and a half dozen blanks.
I want you to say that.
All right. How are we doing up there? Love your outfit, Fred.
Thank you so much.
Splendid. I guess we're ready for you, Robert. Charles, what are you doing? A little artwork?
I'm ready. I'm finished already. It's in. The light is on.
Okay. Vinny said, when I was a kid, we were so poor, I had to share a bed with two brothers, three sisters, and a half dozen blanks.
Half a dozen dogs.
Dogs. All right, here we go. Nancy, half dozen dogs is his answer.
Sorry.
Half dozen chickens. All right, Fred.
Keep warm, you know.
Well, the great quotes from John Travolta. I can't believe she did that to me. I can't believe she did that to me. I said bed bugs. They were poor.
That's right.
Tenement house to help them.
Okay, John.
Yeah, I said he had to share a bed with half a dozen neighbors.
That's another good one. Neighbors, relatives, friends, all that.
Like fun.
Aaron?
Well, I didn't say dogs. I said cousins.
Yes, that's another good one. Relatives. Charles?
That's 12 cousins.
12 cousins.
Hmm.
Through no two waiting. Brothers, three sisters, and a partridge in a pear tree. All right, 3-1 the score. Sharon is still ahead. Third and final round, right after this.
Thank you.
you go first.
Okay.
Eight is. Whoops. There it is. Fat Fred is so fat.
How fat is he?
He hasn't seen parts of his body in years. Last week, Leonard Nimoy went in search of Fat Fred's blank. Aren't you sorry you're not writing?
Yeah, I am.
Well, write one anyway. Give it to her.
Thank you, please.
That's it. It's fun. It's a fun question.
In search of Walter Mondale.
All right, here we go. Fat Fred is so fat, Sharon, he hasn't seen parts of his body in years. Last week, Leonard Nimoy went in search of Fat Fred's blank.
Feet?
Feet is good. That's good. If he was really rotund and portly, he could not see his feet, so that's a logical answer.
I think this should win for her.
How about toes? Toes and feet with that man.
Oh!
They say no. I'm with you. They say no.
We want a recount.
All right. What have you got? Have you got feet for her?
No, I'm afraid I don't. You know how the folds, when a person is really fat, they kind of obscure your navel.
Oh, you go in search of another good,
yeah.
Another good one. Yeah, feet, navel.
Belly button.
Belly button it is. So, Sharon, you remain at three, and that gives Robert a chance to catch up with you. Let's see if he does it right now. With this is your last chance. You need two to tie and three to win, Robert. Harry said that fast food restaurant is a real ripoff. I ordered the quarter pounder, and the only thing that weighed a quarter pound was a blank. The only thing that weighed a quarter pound was the blank. Understand, Robert? Good. Just found out Robert is a Shakespearean scholar. Our own Robert Malchewski.
I always imagine Stallone.
Stallone.
Stallone is Hamlet.
Yeah, that's good.
Hey, yo, Adrian, to be or not to be, huh? Come here, you know.
Okay, Robert. Harry said that fast food restaurant is a real ripoff. I ordered the quarter pounder, and the only thing that weighed a quarter pound was a blank.
The bun.
Was the bun. That's a good one. The bun is a good one, right?
Obviously the only answer.
Right. Oh, yeah. I love buns.
I went to a fast food restaurant.
I said the check.
All right, now it's 3-2. You need one more to tie, Robert. Let's see if John gives you a bun.
Check, Gene.
Check. Oh. All right, you got two more shots at it here.
You're in lack, Flint.
Tie score. Charles, it all depends on you.
I went with the other guy. Check.
Check.
Well, it's a tie.
All right, so the game ends in a tie. That means we have to go to a tiebreaker.
Means it doesn't end at all.
I don't get
We've
you
got
right.
to find a winner, and so I'll push the thing here and reveal the tie-breaking question. Here it is. Water blank. Water blank. Water now, blank. In front of you, but out of sight of the stars, are four good responses to this. Water blank. Your seats were determined by lot, and the rule is, Sharon, that you go first. Tell me which answer you want by number. Don't say any words. Just give me a number. Water blank. You want one, two, three, or four?
Two, please.
You want number two? I'll give that to you. Robert, which number do you want?
Number three.
Number three is your response. And I'm going to go over here and canvas the stars and get their responses. As soon as you hear your answer, you will make some sort of demonstration. Light a flare or something like that and let me know. All right, Nancy, you're up first. These are verbal responses.
Oh.
Just water blank. What do you say?
Melon.
Watermelon. Neither one of them has that. There. Fred, what do you say?
Waterloo.
Waterloo. Does anybody have a water? What do you say?
I said waterfall.
Waterfall.
Yes.
Yeah.
Robert
has waterfall. Come on down,
Robert. Thank you. Thank you.
All right.
I certainly would please.
Hey there. Sharon, good luck to you in your blessed event coming up. We're going to send some gifts your way. I hope they'll do you in good stead. Sharon Sawhill.
Hey there.
Now,
Now we're going to go to the Hollywood Squares part of it. Here comes the rest of the set. Three stars will appear as if by magic. John and I will switch places. We've got lots more excitement coming up here. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar stylish video cassette recorder that combines the convenience of front loading with the performance of the two-track four-head system furnished by Quasar. And now it's time for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour with... from Scarecrow and Mrs. King, Martha Smith. From another world, Christopher Rich. And from Greenhouse, Bob Eubanks. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John.
Yes, well done. Okay. Congratulations. I know, it's tough up there, isn't it? Yes, Robert Malcheski, but you did very, very well. You've made it through the Hollywood Squares. We have three new stars. We have Martha Smith. We have Christopher Rich. And Bob Eubanks. Okay, Christopher Rich from the show Another World.
Yes.
Yesterday you had an interesting day on our program, didn't you?
Yes, I have a tremendous record going. It's clear that I can't get a single answer right.
Yes, you were nothing for about five or six, I believe.
He endeared himself to us all because of it.
But today, I promise I'm going to get at least one right. But you won't know which one it is, so it's your tough luck.
The most charming loser we've ever had.
Yes, I would tend to agree. Okay, first we'll see if you get called on. Let's go over here and play Hollywood Squares. There we go. You're in that funny seat. Okay, we're going to begin the game in just a second. First, we will introduce ourselves once again to our defending champ, Charlotte T-O-E-R-C-K Turk.
Yes.
Okay, she is returning. It's her third day, $33,200. This is staggering. You can
fantastic.
Buy many more colors of eye makeup with this kind
that's
of money.
Right.
What are your thoughts at this point?
I'm thrilled.
You're thrilled?
I've had a great time.
Are you in shock?
I'm in shock, yes.
Okay, well, come out of shock to play Hollywood Squares at least one more time. Okay, and we're going to play it until we have a winner, and the winner goes on to Supermatch for up to $30,000. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square. And, of course, you get to start, Charlotte. Pick a star. Let's
Fred,
get going.
Please.
Okay, Mr. Travellina in the center square.
Yes, yes, yes.
Who is older, Fred? Sylvester Stallone or the oldest living gorilla in captivity?
Do the gorilla first.
Hey, yo, come here, gorilla, come here.
Is that the gorilla?
Sylvester Stallone or the oldest living gorilla in captivity?
Right.
The oldest living gorilla in captivity.
Is older.
Yes.
What do you say, Charlotte?
I'll agree.
Yes, the oldest living gorilla in captivity is older. You're right to agree. Begin the square because the oldest gorilla just turned 53. Sylvester Stallone is a mere pup of 37. Okay, Robert, your move. You're playing O.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Yes.
According to the old Farmer's Almanac, Gene.
Yep.
You can tell a spring chicken from an old hen by touching its breast.
Watch my hand go out of the frame.
You can look, but you better not touch, honey.
Okay.
That's will foul. The breast... Enough, fal-de-ral. Will the breast of a spring chicken be soft or firm to the touch?
Versus what? You tell a spring,
the spring chicken from an old hen. Yeah. Will the spring chicken be soft or firm?
By touching the breast.
Right.
Spring chicken, be soft or firm. It's one of the two, isn't it?
Right. Presumably the old hen will be the other.
Yeah. I would say the old hen, you know, you get older and those things happen. It's part of life in the fowl world, just as it is in the human world.
So you're saying the old hen will be soft to the touch, so
right.
The spring chicken will be firm.
Exactly.
Okay. He says the spring chicken will be firm. Agree or disagree, Robert?
I agree.
The spring chicken will be soft. No. You should have disagreed with Gene, and your opponent gets that square and gets off to a pretty good start in this game because you got two X's up there, and you're playing X. Pick a star.
Bob to win.
Bob Eubanks. Which happened first? Donny Osmond's first TV appearance or the first use of dental floss?
I really believe that... dental floss has been around longer than Donny Osmond's first television appearance. I would say dental floss.
Hey, this could win you the game. Agree or disagree? Dental floss.
I'll agree.
Dental floss has been around longer. Yes, right to agree. You have to square. You do win the game. There are three X's up there in a row, and $175 on your side of the ledger. We're going to clear the board. Boy, that was quick. We'll clear the board and move right on to the next game. We are zipping right along. Robert, you get to start this one because you're behind. You lost the last game.
Fred, please.
Mr. Travellina.
Yes.
You're in India. You're in India. It's lunchtime, and you're dying for a hamburger and a Coke. Now, which one is impossible to buy there? The hamburger or the Coca-Cola? One of them's impossible.
I would say that that would be the hamburger because of the sacred cows, so I would say that the Coke you can buy there. The hamburger you cannot buy.
It is impossible to buy hamburger in India. Agree or disagree, Robert?
I agree.
It is impossible to buy Coca-Cola in India. No, you should have disagreed with Fred. And your opponent gets that first square. I don't know, it could have fooled me. Okay, we're going to be back to complete this $200 game right after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Thank you.
Turk, you're playing next. Pick a star.
Bob, please.
Bob Eubanks.
John Bauman.
You are a rabbit breeder.
Well, that's weird, man.
You're a rabbit breeder, and your male buck rabbit has already bred 3 female rabbits this week.
The hussy.
Now, should he go on to breed at least 30 more times? Or should the buck stop here? Sorry.
He should only do it for dough. Hey, those suckers can get it on. I think he should just continue. Yeah. 30 more.
Okay.
Thumper would.
Charlotte, he says, breed him 30 more times. No problem. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
The buck should stop at 3. No, you should have disagreed. Bob does not know his rabbit breeding. Very funny, though. Your opponent gets that square. Breeding your rabbit more than 3 times a week will cause him to lose potency.
No.
Wouldn't want that to happen. Okay, Robert. Robert, you're playing. Oh, pick a star.
Charles, please.
Charles. Charles, you have just walked through a swamp in your brand new pair of Gucci loafers. According to the Italian Shoe Center, to dry your shoes, should you put them in front of your fireplace or leave them out in the hall?
I wish I could talk Italian, but I can't. I say leave them in the hall. I think to dry them might be detrimental, but don't let me influence you, Robert.
Agree or disagree? You should leave them in the hall, Robert.
I disagree.
You should leave them in the hall. You should have agreed with Charles. No, your opponent gets that square. Leather shoes should not be put in front of a direct heat source. Okay, Charlotte, that gives you a big advantage. Pick a star.
Martha to win.
Martha Smith from Scarecrow and Mrs. King for a game win and a big lead.
Martha.
Hi.
Martha, you just lost a tooth. Until you get to the dentist, you should soak it in something. Is it milk, alcohol, or saliva?
Wait, I'm taking it. He's going to put it back in.
Pull that headband a little tighter, Martha. Everything will be okay.
I don't understand.
No. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I suppose that makes sense.
No,
hey, you got a headband for me because I'm losing
about
this.
That question makes
no,
sense.
Okay, you lost
the
tooth.
I lost a tooth.
Right, and I guess
I'm
presumably
on the way
you
to
want
to. Her
yeah, you want to preserve it, and you're going to put
like
it back.
Oh, like bronze it or something for my shelf?
You're going to try to replace it, right? You're going to try to replace it.
Okay, fine. And should I show?
So you should soak it in milk, alcohol, or saliva. Pick one.
You should soak it in milk.
Agree or disagree, Charlotte, for the game?
I'm going to agree.
You should soak it in milk. You're right to agree. You get the square, and you win the game. Makes perfect sense. Okay, very well done. $450 over there, $25 over here. But there's still time. We're going to sweep all the X's and that single O off of the board, and we're going to start a $300 game. You are going to start, Robert.
Fred again, please.
Fred Travellina.
Yeah. Not Travolta, Trevino, or Travanti. Travellina.
When President Reagan gets up in the morning. You want to do the old gorilla now? Sorry. When President Reagan gets up in the morning, does he go into the bathroom and shave himself?
Or his wife? And he should.
Does he go into the bathroom and shave himself? Or does the White House barber do it for him?
Well, sometimes the White House barber will. Sometimes. No,
the White House barber shaves him.
Agree or disagree that the White House barber shaves President Reagan?
I agree.
He goes into the bathroom and he shaves himself. Let's give the president a hand. win. He saves himself. And your opponent, unfortunately for you, gets that square. Okay, he can cut himself shaving, but can he cut the budget deficit? We may find out after these messages. See you then.
Join me, Bob Eubanks, for Newlywed Game episodes not seen for nearly 20 years.
Just wait till we get home.
Every night at 8 on Buzzer.
We've got a $300 game here. Charlotte, it's your move. You're playing X.
Bob, please.
Bob Eubanks.
Hey, the people really ought to come down and watch this show because while we're in commercial, John goes out there and he does dip, 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 dip things and all of that. And it really is worth it. It's worth the show, really. Wonderful.
Hey, yip, 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 boom, 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 boom. Good
job.
Your question, Bob. Bob, you have a pet male sheep.
Oh, no.
You did so well with the rabbits, Bob. You know, we can't.
Who you didn't see the U-turn, right?
He's been the goat.
No, he was the goat.
Wait. Boy, is he on the notes. This gets worse. You have a pet male sheep. Will your sheep try to mate with your dog? Or does he only have eyes for use?
No, pal.
There's still a game here. Let's try to answer these questions.
Take it back. You really shouldn't come down to watch this show. Would my sheep try to
mate with
my
dog?
Dog?
Right.
What do they know?
No kidding. That. Wow, man.
I need an answer, though, pretty quick, because we're in our last...
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. My sheep would. My sheep is a little weird.
Your sheep would try to mate with
you. Yeah.
Okay, agree or disagree, Charlotte?
I will agree.
Your sheep only has eyes for yous, dear. No, you should have disagreed. And your opponent gets that square.
That sounds so weird, man.
Okay, so we got an X and we got an O up on the board. And Robert, you are playing O.
Martha, please.
Martha Smith.
Yes. No tooth questions. No sheep, no dogs, no rats, no teeth.
You have very little control over this, Martha. You're a respectable, unmarried, church-going woman.
There you go, Martha. There's one.
No, thank you, John. Question. Thank you.
And your problem is...
My problem is...
Your problem is you sleep with every man you like. According to Dear Abby...
I have a sheep question.
There are no dogs.
You didn't know according when you were well off. According to Dear Abby, should you practice saying no 100 times a day, or should you join Sexaholics Anonymous?
It's worked wonders for me. I would say yes, definitely join Sexaholics Anonymous. It's a great group. Try.
Agree or disagree, Robert?
I agree.
He agrees.
You should join Sexaholics Anonymous. Well, we're all in agreement. Right after this game. But for right now, an O goes up there. And Charlotte, you are playing X. Make your move.
Chris to Black.
This is it, Chris.
There you go.
Okay, you missed this one. Robert takes the game and gets pretty much back into the thick of things.
Okay, I'm ready.
Chris, Rich, yep, from another world.
He joined Sexaholics Anonymous and it worked.
You had a rough day in the rumpus room. Don't listen to her, she's only your wife. Okay. You had a rough day in the rumpus room and your ping pong balls got dented. What does Consumer Guide say you should do? Should you boil them or buy new ones?
Well, pal, I don't know about you, but I'm sure not going to boil mine. I didn't know you could buy new ones, but I'd go with buy new ones. You know, what can you do?
He says you should buy new ones for a block. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
That is why you're the champ, because you should boil them. You are right to disagree. That amazes me. You get the dents out of it.
100%.
Okay, you can boil the dents out of your ping pong balls. Very important information. And you get to block. So, Robert, the shoe is on the other foot, and it's your move. You're playing next.
Aaron to block.
Right.
Aaron.
Right.
Go, baby, go.
No, go for it.
Aaron and friend.
Aaron and friend. Cute.
Just got that, Aaron. You want an excuse to cut school, okay? So you drink a cup of hot tea and run to the infirmary to have your temperature taken. Can your scheme work, or will drinking something hot have no effect at all?
Yeah, it'll work.
The scheme will work.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, for a block, agree or disagree, Robert?
I agree.
The scheme can work. Yes, you are right to agree. You get the straight, you do block. Drinking something hot, in other words, can in fact raise your temperature. That is the time's up bell. She has done it again. $500. Charlotte Firm, congratulations. Zip right over there to G. Graver. Yes, she's a vet. She's a veteran of this game. She knows exactly what to do. Robert, I know you're still looking at that. What went wrong? I can tell you what went wrong. It's that one pivotal question right in that last game on the top row, because you might have forged from behind otherwise. You're a very good player, very competitive.
Thank you.
Congratulations. $100, Robert Malczewski.
Thank you very much.
Attaboy. Gene Rayburn, take it away.
Okay, John. All right, we congratulate you. We'll be back with you and our 9 stars for Go with the Big Money right after this.
Up next, if you love Family Feud, you will love the mini marathon starting next. Go on, wake up your family and play along. You'll be glad you did. Not so sure how glad they'll be.
Thank you, Johnny. Oh, well, Charlotte, you've got over $33,000. This is getting to be old hat to you, right?
No.
No. All right, let's see how much, if you win, 30, 20, how much you will win here in the Super Match. We polled a studio audience a short while ago and said, please write down your best answer to this. Blank, Georgia. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $1,000. For naming the second most popular answer, it's $500, and the third, $250. All right, let's see which of the three of the nine stars you'll call on.
John.
It depends a little on when it was, but for this minute, Boy George.
All right, Boy George is one.
Fred.
All right, let's say King George.
King George.
Okay. Bob.
St. George.
St. George. All right. He's the one who slew the dragon, right? So you have Boy George, King George, and St. George. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What's your pleasure?
I'll hope it was a recent audience and say Boy George.
Boy George? All right. You think she's right, right?
Either this one or
that. All right. Let's find out if she is right and if you're right. We'll begin by revealing the $250 response. Phyllis George.
Sure.
Oh, yes.
You remember him,
we
don't
remember
you?
Him.
All right. The next one says...
Queen of England,
they're
wasn't
cool.
She?
Gorgeous George.
Gorgeous
you remember
George.
Her, don't you?
Uh-oh, we're in trouble. I can't believe she's in
Last
trouble.
Last chance for Boy George.
You know what it's going to be.
Here we go. Yeah! Congratulations. All right, you got the $1,000. Now it's time to go to the head-to-head match with one of the stars. You have to make a selection here, and after you do, that star will reveal the hidden number, and we'll multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. It'll be a 10, a 20, or 30. I don't think you can lose anywhere here. Either it's 10,000, 20,000, or 30,000. Good luck to you.
I'm going to stick with John.
Third day in a row for John. All right, John, you had a 21 day, a 10 the next day, and let's see what it is today. $10,000 is what you're playing for.
Not bad.
All right. It'll put you over the $40,000 mark if you do indeed match John with this. Blank century. Blank century. C-E-N-T-U-R-Y. Okay, you have to match him to collect the money. That's the final hurdle. What do you say?
20th century.
20th century sounds good to me.
We'll
find out now if John agrees.
Yeah!
20th century! Yay! Yay, Charlotte!
You are a big winner.
Charlotte is really a big winner. You have $44,700. Wow! All right, we'll be back with Charlotte the Stars right after this.
Thank you.
All right, we want to find out which one of the stars had the big number. Would you all grab the tabs? Ready, set, go. Bob Eubanks of Dream House.
The sheep and rabbit specialist.
Right. We thank you all. It's been like old home week here to have NBC stars here. Nancy and Chris from Another World. Bob Eubanks from Dream House. And we hope to see all of you here, back here on the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. You were excellent.
They were terrible.
Martha, would you just walk down here and say goodbye to Charlotte, please?
Let's bronze them all.
Just say goodbye to Charlotte.
Oh.